Hi everybody, this is Janice. I'm an application developer from Keysight Technologies. ICAP started to support Python 3 programming from version 2022. In this video, we will talk about how to get started with Python programming in ICAP. Here are the two demos we will cover today. In demo 1, we will introduce how to create a new Python script in ICAP from scratch. And in demo 2, we will demonstrate an ICAP example and explain how to use it in ICAP. Let's now start with the demo 1. Step 1. In the ICAP main window, let's create a new MDL file and name it python_demo. Then we double-click to open this file and go to the micro page. Create a new micro named hello. Note that in ICAP there are two places that we can apply Python script. One is in micro, as we demonstrate now, another is in transform. We will talk about it in the next demo case. Now we need to choose Python global namespace. We can then type in the script in the editor field in Python 3 syntax. Okay, now let's type in a equals to hello world, then print a. Let's execute the micro. We can see the output will be shown in the ICAP status window. Next, we can try to import an ICAP function and use it. We type in from ICAP import icfunc as f. Then we define a b equals f.get_int. Please input a number. Then print b. Let's run this. ICAP function getInt will ask user to input an int number. We can input any int number freely, say 22, and we could use this number for calculation later in the script. But for this time, let's just print it. Here is our input number printed in the status window. This demo shows how we get started with a Python script in the ICAP from the very beginning, and we could move forward and go program using Python 3 in the editor. We usually don't need to start everything from scratch. ICAP provides many great examples as a starting point, so I will show you how to use our Python 3 example in the next demo. We start with open an existing example under the ICAP root folder. This demo shows a few Python examples that use matplotlib, NumPy, and pandas. In this video, I will cover how to filter and sort data to create a trend or scaling plot using pandas data frames. The setup idvd_alldata represents a collection of data of multiple devices measured at different temperatures. We go to trend plots. At the setup level, Python scripts are in the extract optimize tab. Here we can write transforms using Python. The main difference between a micro and a transform is that a transform returns a dataset array. Here we can see the Python script editor. The keywords are in blue, the strings are in green, and the commas are in gray. Let's have a quick look at what the Python code does. The first part of a Python script typically uses the import keyword to import a module or a package. We can import the whole library or import certain functions. Here we import some packages like pandas, numpy, and the ICAP module. We import the data from the old data setup. Then we put the data into a pandas data frame. Here is a filter block. We define the geometry information and bias to get the filtered data. For example, with this definition, we get ID set setup. Then we sort the data by temperature and L. Finally, the resulting data frame is converted back into input-output in the local setup, so that we can simulate. At last, display the new trend plot. Let's run this transform. Here is the original data and our generated trend plot. Now you know how to run the Python example, and let's move forward to modify the script. We try to add a new filter t equals to 25. Give me a single line of ID versus L. Try to execute this modified script. Here we are, the room temperature ID set trend plot. We could further modify the filter to get more IDS trend plot. We may need to change more blocks, such as plot display. But this example is a good starting point, and it demonstrates how Python 3 works in the ASCII. And that concludes this video. To get the demo files, please go to the example folder after the installation of ASCII. To learn more about Python programming in ASCII, please refer to the ASCII help file. We have a chapter to explain all the details about Python application in ASCII. Subscribe to our channel, Keysight Design Software, for more videos and to get the latest updates. Thanks for watching!